Hi, in this video I will show you how to move your Ethereum validator from your i5 to your i7. So we're looking at my i5 right now and I'm running the Get Ethereum node and the Prism beacon chain package as well as the Prism validator package. I'm now switching to the i7 and I will show you what packages you need to install beforehand before you can start transferring your validator. So I'm migrating to this combination here. I'm running the Geth client as execution client and the Teku client for the beacon chain. So you will have to install these packages first. You can also choose Prism over Teku, but for the sake of client diversity, I would really urge you to choose Teku. And then you will have to let those packages sync, and then we can start with the next steps. Besides the two packages, you will also need your staking keys, which you use to first initiate your validator back in the day. Please don't use them yet. We still are running the old validator, and running the same key files on two validators is illegal and will get you slashed on the network, so we don't want that. So I will show you now how you can stop your old validator, so we can start with the new one. So first off, you will have to go to your validator package, in my case Prism, and you can see your public key there and can just remove it with one click. So you are removing the validator, so it should stop working. So after removing the validator, you should reload the page and it should look like this. There should be no active public key anymore. So now I'm waiting two epochs. I will miss some attestations, but it's really just a negative reward. So you will just lose the same amount you would have earned. And it's a really small amount and really nothing compared to the risk of getting slashed. To confirm that your validator is currently offline and not attesting anymore, you can go to the Beacon Chain validator website where you can see your validator and check for the attestations, and then you just wait until you see at least two, but I would suggest you wait for three missed attestations. That means you waited three epochs, and then we remove all the validator related packages on the old device to be absolutely sure that our validator is not running anymore. So as you can see here, I've waited a few epochs and have now three missed attestations in a row, and will now go back to my old device and delete all the validator related packages. So now to remove your old packages, you will have to go to my dApps, and I will start by removing the Prism validator I was previously running. Therefore I will go to manage package and then remove package, and then I will confirm the removal again, and now I can be absolutely sure that my keys are also removed, because the package will also remove every related data that came with it. You can now also do that for the Geth package. I will do it as well. The Prism beacon chain, I use that for another dev as well, so I will keep that, but you should be good by just removing the execution client and the validator package. So now I will be reconnecting to my AVADO i7. And as you can see, I have the two necessary packages installed, the Geth package and the Teku package. And now I will double check that the Geth package is synced correctly. I will first show you the option to do it in the logs. So if you go to the logs, it should look like this. But you can also just check it on the homepage to see if the Geth package is synced correctly. So next, I will open the Teku package through my dApps. By clicking on the package name, it will open a new window where you see a banner reminding you that you still need to update your recipient address. So we will do that first. So if you now click on the red banner, you will immediately go to the settings tab, and if you scroll down a little bit, you will see the empty box where you can insert your ETH1 address as recipient address. After you're done, just click apply changes, and the banner at the top of the site should disappear. after you applied the changes and reloaded the page, the package will restart, and you can see on the right, in the right hand corner, that the package is syncing once again, and it should turn green after a while. So now you can see that it synced for me, so it's green again, and now the add validator button appears, and we can now start adding our validator here. So now if you click on add a validator, you will have to upload your key store file and type in the password you set when you created those keys. So now click on add validator. It should then start to look like this. And if it's not looking like this for you, then please try to refresh the page. So now you can click on your validator here on the Teku page, and it will lead you to the beacon chain validator page we visited before. And now you can see your missed attestations here. But if you refresh for the next epoch, you should see that you are attesting again. So there should be an attestation that you didn't miss. So after waiting a couple of minutes, I will now refresh the page. And as you can see, I'm attesting again. And this means that I've successfully moved the validator to the new device. Congratulations on moving your validator to your new device, and I will see you in the next tutorial. Bye bye.